I'm Andy Ori. I am a general manager and a VP at Juniper Networks. I work in the AI-driven enterprise business unit. I am a former co-founder of 128 Technology, and prior to that, I was a co-founder and CEO of Acme Packet, which we eventually sold to Oracle. You know, what's interesting is before we met Juniper, we were talking relentlessly about the fact that the only reason people use networks today is to deliver and consume applications and services. It's not about remote access to computing, and it's not really about sharing bits of data. It's about consuming and delivering services and applications. And every service and application has one commonality, and that is that there's associated session state. So being able to understand, manage, and route the associated session state with the service or application being delivered is really fundamental to being able to say, I can control and deliver the quality of the experience that the enterprise and the individual need to feel like this communication makes sense. When we met Juniper, Juniper was talking about experience being the new uptime. And experiences are all about what networking is for. It's amazing that the two of us saw this at the same time. We've been able to integrate with them because they have the full stack at the enterprise edge and they have all of the cloud AI. And when you throw in session smart networking, it's that missing piece that really allows you to deliver the complete vision of a secure, high quality experience that enables really impactful business outcomes. The truth is that tunnels are an RFC from 1995. Tunnels principally were designed to deal with the fact that I had a private address behind a firewall, because that was the only notion of security I had, that I needed to connect over the public internet to another private address behind another firewall. Private, public, private connectivity. And so by putting in place a tunnel with some VRF functionality, I'm able to affect that kind of routing. But it's 25, 30 years behind the time. And it's static, and it consumes an awful lot of overhead. So if you were to just look at your network and you were to connect via tunnels and then connect not using tunnels, you'd save 30 to 50% of your overhead. Now, that may not be a big deal until you realize that most of the MPLS connectivity in the United States is T1 connectivity. It's 1.5 megabits per second. It's not a lot. 50% overhead is a lot. And then we've seen that when people implement tunnel-free architectures, quality killing latency decreases by 50%. Truth of the matter is that what a tunnel is, it's like a straw where I can connect to you, but if you get hacked, you can connect to me. I don't want that. I want a way that I can connect to my application securely in a cloud. But if the cloud gets compromised, I don't want a trapdoor with an enhanced attack surface area through my firewall in my enterprise. And so we look at tunnels and we say there has to be a better way. Tunnels will go away because they cost too much, they are static, they make it very difficult to scale, and they just don't provide the security that people need.